اوكي ناو وي ريكوردينج. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is the second lesson of نور الإيضاح in the Hanafi فقه, Hanafi jurisprudence. Last time we talked about excuse me, last time we talked about كتاب الطهارة, the chapter about purification, and when we started the chapter, we're still in that chapter. We talked about the type of water, and we talked about the classification of whether the which water can be used to make wudu and which one can be used. So we said there is absolute water, which is pure in itself and has ability of purification or purifying others or for wudu purpose. And we said there is pure in itself and also it has that ability, but using it is makruh, which is basically the water, the absolute water. But if a cat or something similar drank from it, and then the third was tahir bin tahir, which basically it's pure in itself. So you can drink, you can use for other purposes, but you cannot use to make wudu. And the fourth was dirty or filthy water, which you can't use. And the fifth was doubtful water, which basically water that himar, donkey, or mule drank from it. Right. In this course, we're just basically reading and having a very brief explanation of the book. Next course, inshallah, we'll have another more in-depth explanation, and we will then talk about why the donkey and the mule, like the water that they drank from it, is doubtful. Right, but basically, yeah, I mean, basically, since we talked about it anyway, so the reason is basically that the donkey, while it's meat, you cannot drink, can eat donkey, so its meat is not edible. However, its sweat is tahir, because the Prophet, peace be upon him, and the Sahaba and everybody were used to ride them, and the donkey will sweat, and that sweat will come to the touch and basically be and the legs and the clothes of the Prophet, peace be upon him, whoever is riding it, and they will pray without changing the clothes or cleaning it or anything like that. And therefore, there is a contradiction in the whether the donkey is pure or not. Now, you cannot eat its meat, which is in line with or basically. You can't eat that non-pure, purified, or whatever you can't clean is something that you cannot eat. Sorry, you can't, whatever you can't eat is something that is not clean or mostly. But at the same time, the donkey sweat is good. So basically, what we do with it, it's now became doubtful. The water that they drank from. Anyway, we'll address that inshallah. Or in-depth courses. Anyway, now we'll start with the another faslun. Faslun means section. So we started with a book or a chapter. The book, and the book is basically this divided into chapters, chapters into fasl, which is sections. The Sheikh is saying, radiallahu anhu, wa rahimahullah, wa nafa'ana bi'ulumi, wal ma'ul qaleel. The little water, not too much water. If an animal drank from it, it can be divided into four classes or four types. And it's called su'ran. Su'ran is the leftover. So basically, if there is a pond or a small puddle of water or bucket or whatever, just small amount of water, and an animal drank from it. After drinking, we're not talking about what the animal drank. The animal drank is basically in his body. That's on the side. What we are talking about is it's left over, because as an animal, or as the animal is drinking, his saliva will mix with the water, and some of it will mix with whatever is left. So what can we do with that water now? Can we use it or not for wudu and ghusl and so on? Now, it's four types. The first time is tahirun mutahhir, ghayru makruh. So basically, it's similar to absolute water in the other classification we talked about last time. And it's pure in itself, and it has the ability to purify in wudu and so on. And that is basically the water that آدمي أو فرس أو ما يؤكل لحمه أكل منه. So شرب منه, sorry. So if human or horse or anything that is edible drank from that water, then you can use it, no problem. It is not makruh, it is similar to the absolute water, it's good. So for example, you may have a bottle of water and then you drink a little bit from it, and maybe you give your friends or whatever, and then some of it remains and you want to make wudu, you can still use the remaining, the leftover to make wudu. Now, the second type is najis, dirty, filthy. You cannot use it. And that is something, the water that a dog or a pig or a predator, animate predator like wolf or something like that, basically drank from it. والثالث مكروه استعماله مع وجود غيره. The third type of classification is it's مكروه, disliked. If you have something else. If you don't have something else and that's only available words, then you can use it without كراهة, with no dislikings. But if another water is available, then it's better to use other water. And that is basically the water that a cat drank from it, or chicken, but the chicken al-mukhalla. Al-mukhalla means it is left to eat from wherever it lies. So it may come to like filth, or eat something that's not clean or dirty. And that's why it's peak, and its saliva may get mixed with something that's dirty, and therefore when such a chicken drink from the water, then it becomes makruh. However, if it is not mukhalla, if you have control over what it eats and what it drinks and whatever, when it drinks, there is no problem. والسباع الطير is bird predators like a snake. وسواكن البيوت may inhabit or inhabit like the house or the home, especially maybe in the countryside, something like that. House, لا العقرب, not the scorpion. In other copy, والعقرب. So basically also the fourth is basically the مشكوك في طهوريته. If a donkey or mule drank that little water, then it becomes doubtful. Now, here is an interesting case. It's actually, I think, it's a very famous puzzle, and I think we had that puzzle during Ramadan, I think, in the group, and it's basically فإن لم يجد غيره توضأ به وتيمم ثم صلى. So if somebody didn't find anything except that water where which basically a mule or a donkey drank from, what should you do then? The answer is you do wudu, توضأ به وتيمم. So basically you do wudu first and then you do tayammum and then you can pray. And the sequence is important. So you use it for wudu and therefore it's done. It's no more water. Okay. And if that water is or can be used for purification, then you use it, no problem. If not, then you do tayammum. Now, if you mix it, then you may have a problem, because if you mix, if you do tayammum, not a problem, but basically it doesn't work the same way, because if you do tayammum and the water is available, then tayammum is inapplicable. In order for you to do tayammum, the water should not be available. But anyway, فصل is there any question so far? Any questions? No questions? Okay. فصل section. لو اختلط أوان أكثرها طاهر تحرى للتوضؤ والشرب. If we have buckets of water and they've been put together and then you learned or you realize that some of it is not clean or got mixed with a filth or dirt or whatever, or something that dirty, not dirt, something filthy or dirty. What can you do? Now, if you are aware, if you know that most of the buckets are clean, but there are a couple of them or few of them basically not clean, what should you do? You do your best to try to identify which ones are clean, which ones has got mixed with filth, and then you can use all of them, or basically what you identify it as clean or pure, you can use them to make wudu and to drink. If, however, most of them, of the buckets, were actually not pure, then you can't do investigation to find out whether you can make wudu or not. You cannot make wudu. But you do that investigation and try as best to identify the clean ones for drinking. So basically, let's say we have 10 buckets of water, and then you thought they were clean, and then somebody came and told you, oh, I knew there were two of these 10 buckets got mixed with drops of blood, for example, or urine, or liquor, or anything like that that turned it into filth. But two of them were mixed. I had marked them, but now I don't see the mark, and they were basically added to the other buckets. I don't know which ones are they. Now, you ask him how many were there. He said we were two, three, or four. They are less than half. Then you basically try at best to identify them. You look into the water, you see which one has made color change, has smell change or anything like that, and which one maybe the bucket still has the mark. If to the best of your ability, and then identify the clean, the pure six. You got them done, fine, you can use those six. What happens if one of those six were actually one of that not clean one? No problem. Since you made your investigation and the majority of them were actually clean or pure, then you are fine. If most of those were actually not clean, then you cannot use all of those buckets for wudu, but you can use some of them for drinking, but you still need to investigate and try to identify as much as you can. Now, if the issue or this issue was in clothes, not bucket of water, but clothes, what should you do? Basically, you investigate and try to identify the clean and pure one. Regardless of whether they have most of those clothes got mixed with or we're clean or not. It doesn't matter. So there is no, but if three, you know, were clean and seven weren't, and they got mixed, you do identification, and basically you use them for wudu, for praying and wudu and so on, or during prayer. Any questions so far? Moving on to the other section. No. Right, so now we move on to wells of water. If you have water wells and some dirt or dirty or filthy material elements or something like that fell into it, what can you do? What should you do with this water in the well? Now, the action that you're going to be doing is basically نزح البئر. نزح meaning taking the displacing the water. So basically, you remove the water from the well. You take it out, all of it, all of the water. You can give it to the animals to drink and whatever, but basically, you can't use that water yourself. And so, what is the purpose? Then, what is the point? The point is the well, usually, it will have, because it balances with the water underneath the ground, the underground water, and basically, it got into the well. And it balances. When you take all the water in the well out, it will that bucket of the well will basically start being refilling again with the underground water. So that refill, that is going to be clean water that you can use. All right. So that's basically the action. The action is displacement, removing the either all the water in the well, or certain amount depends on the situation which we're going to talk about. All right. So if let's say تنزح البئر الصغيرة بوقوع نجاسة وإن قلت من غير الأروى, meaning if if you have a water well and basically dirty or filthy element fell into it, you need to take that out. You need to take some water out the bit. And even if the from the well, I mean, and even if the that fell was so level, doesn't matter. So it doesn't matter, okay? Even if it is so level, you still need to take out some water of the well. Except al-arwah, the plural of rawat. Rawat, which is basically the dung or the drops of animals, because the drops of animals have certain situation, other situation. So, what is the first thing that we're going to talk about that you need to remove the water from the well? If it got dropped into the well, basically the first thing is كقطرات دم أو خمر. So drop of blood, even just one drop of blood, will turn the well into the small well into najasa, becomes najasa, najis, and you cannot use it for wudu. Or a drop of liquor, خمر. وبوقوع خنزير ولو خرج حيا ولم يصب فمه الماء. And if a pig fell in the well, even if it didn't die inside the well, even if it the pig was removed from the well or left the whale alive. And even if the mouth of the pig did not touch the water, it doesn't matter because the entire body of the pig is filth. وبموت كلب أو شاة أو آدمي فيها. And if a dog or a share like a sheep or similar animal or Adam, human, died in the well. So if it didn't die, that's a different situation. We're talking about now if it died. So if a dog or a sheep or similar or human died inside a well, then you take out the entire water from the well. وبانتفاخ حيوان ولو صليبا. And if there is an animal that died and basically got swollen, you know, an animal died, it's swollen, swollen start like decomposing and so on. So once that happens, even if it was a very small animal, you need to remove, displace the entire water in the well at this time. All right, so what happens if you can take all the water? So sometimes maybe the rate of the well being refilled is so fast that when you take a bucket out, it just the groundwater fills the well right away. So what can you do? No matter how fast you are trying to get the water out of the well, it will just be refilled immediately. So what you do in this situation? The Sheikh is telling you, وينزح مئة دلو لو لم يمكن نزحها. If you are unable to displace the entire water in the well, you basically take out 200 buckets. Right. Moving on. وإن مات فيها دجاجة أو هرة أو نحوها. If a small animal died in the well, you take out 40 buckets. لازم نزح 40 دلوا. وإن مات فيها فأرة أو نحوها. Now talking like an even smaller animal, fowl, mouse, or something similar. لازم نسحب 20 دلوا, 20 bucket. And by doing that, all what we talked about, whether depending on the scenario or the situation, whether to remove the entire or displace the entire water in the well at the moment and wait for it to get refilled, or whether take the 200 well buckets if you cannot take out all the water in the same at that moment because of the rate of refilling of the well, or if you take out 40 bucket if small animal like chicken or cat or similar died in it, or if you take 20 bucket if something even smaller died in it, all that is basically purification to the well itself, to the bucket, to the rope that is in the like used in the bucket, and the hands of the person basically doing all this process. ولا تنجس البئر بالبعر والروة والختم. As we talked about the najasa, what we talked about najasa and filth, we said we made an exception. We said غير الأرواح, the dung or the drops of animals, because the drops of animals are actually allowable in the well. They do not turn the well into najis, into filthy, except if they were too many. What is the amount or the threshold that we say there's too many drops, animal drops or dungs done in the well? Two situations or two things. First, if the person looking into the well said, oh, that's too much, like it depends on the judgment call of that person, or when it was it that amount of drops is too many, or like infestation to the extent that when you take bucket out of the well, it will basically have drops. So every bucket you take, it will bring drops with it. That means there are too many, and therefore you need to clean it. ولا يفسد الماء بخرء حمام وعصفور. So basically, if it is drops of pigeon or bird, like a small bird that can, you know, عصفور, what is عصفور? Like sparrow or something like that. That doesn't hurt the bell, the well. It makes it, it doesn't make it filthy or anything. ولا بموت ما لا دم له فيه. Or if something that doesn't have blood, that doesn't have like blood in it, running blood, if it died inside the well, it doesn't impact it. كسمك وضبع وحيوان الماء وبق وذباب وصقور وعقرب. All these are examples of animals, small animals with no running, no blood, like fish, frogs, حيوان الماء, like the animal that lives in the water, بق وذباب وزنبور, all these like flies and the like, wasps and flies, وعقرب, scorpion. ولا بوقوع آدمي وما يؤكل لحمه إذا خرج حيا ولم يكن على بدنه نجاسة. So we talked earlier about a human being or something that is edible fell and died in the water. It basically, you have to do nasp, you have to displace and remove the water. But what if it didn't die? It just fell and came out alive. There is, in this situation, no problem. There's no issue. It doesn't, that doesn't turn that well into najis, except if that animal or the human had filth on the body, and that filth got mixed with the water, and therefore the water comes now with najas. ولا بوقوع بغل وحمار وسباع طير ووحش في الصحيح. Now there is a خلاف, a disagreement among our scholars whether the بغل والحمار, the mule and donkey, والسباع الطير, predators of birds, birds predators, ووحش, like السباع well, if they fell in the sheikh is saying here, is basically again that doesn't affect the well. وإن وصل لعاب الواقع إلى الماء أخذ حكمه. If the animal that fell in the water, its saliva goes with the water, then the water takes that. It depends on what type of animal would fell in. If it is an edible animal, then no problem. If it is bagl wa himar wa sibaa wa sibaa, bagl wa himar, donkey and mule, then it becomes doubtful because it takes the hukm, the judgment of the soul, of the leftover that we talked about earlier. If it is predators of tire and wash and so on, as we talked about here. ووجود حيوان ميت في بئر. If somebody found an animal dead in the well, what they do? And they didn't know when that, like that, that animal died in the water. It's basically ينجسها من يوم وليلة. It becomes like if you didn't know where it fell. If it wasn't swollen, then it is a day, يوم وليلة. If it was swollen, then 3 days and nights. So basically, that is the section about wells. Next time, inshallah, we will continue with al-istinja. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, nastaghfiruka Allahumma min kulli dhanbin wa natubu ilayk, wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sallam taslima katira. Any questions? All right, no more questions. See you next time, inshallah. Salaam alaikum.